Liebe Kolleginnen und Kollegen aus den Parlamenten, meine sehr geehrten Damen und Herren, als stellvertretender Vorsitzender des Ausschusses Digitale Agenda des Deutschen Bundestages darf ich Sie ganz herzlich hier in Berlin willkommen heißen und insbesondere zu der jetzigen Veranstaltung Parliamentary Perspective and Opportunities for Action darf ich Sie ganz herzlich begrüßen. Sie sind, wir alle sind heute Teil einer Premiere, zum ersten Mal in der Geschichte des Internet Governance Forums veranstalten wir im Vorfeld dieser UN-Veranstaltung ein parlamentarisches Networking-Event. Ziel dieses Treffens ist, die digitalpolitisch aktiven Parlamentarier besser zu vernetzen und die Debatten des IGF in die Parlamente dieser Welt zu tragen. Denn oftmals wird der Digitalpolitik nicht der Stellenwert eingeräumt, der ihr eigentlich zustünde. Einer der Politiker, der wie kaum ein anderer für digitale Themen, für das freie, globale, offene Internet und auch ganz im Besonderen für das IGF sich eingesetzt und gekämpft hat, ist Jimmy Schulz, der Vorsitzende des Ausschusses Digitale Agenda im Deutschen Bundestag. Eigentlich sollte er diese Veranstaltung eröffnen, dass nicht er, sondern ich heute hier sitze, hat einen zutiefst traurigen Grund. Jimmy Schulz ist heute Morgen seinem langen Krebsleiden erlegen. Jimmy Schulz hat für die Digitalpolitik Grandioses geleistet. Er hat das Thema ins Parlament getragen. Wir erinnern uns daran, mit welcher Leidenschaft er für die Themen gekämpft hat. Wir erinnern uns auch an den ersten Redner im Deutschen Bundestag mit einem iPad. Wir denken aber vor allem an einen lieben Kollegen und großartigen Menschen. Er wird uns sehr fehlen. Unsere Gedanken sind bei seiner Familie. Und ich bitte Sie, einen kurzen Moment Stille zu halten. Ich danke Ihnen. Das IGF ist die größte globale Bürgerversammlung der digitalen Community. Es ist zugleich Hort einer offenen, freiheitlichen Netzstruktur, genau jener Netzstruktur, die zutiefst zunehmend unter Druck steht. Zurzeit ist in der Debatte hier in Deutschland, aber auch auf internationaler Ebene ein Begriff besonders en vogue: digitale Souveränität. Es ist ein Begriff, mit dem sich jeder anfreunden kann, auch weil so vieles unter ihm verstanden wird. Sowohl eine Welt tatsächlich der digitalen Abschottung, als auch eine Welt, in der die digitale Freiheit und eine offene Netzstruktur bewahrt werden. Lassen Sie uns heute und dauerhaft darum streiten, wie wir der freien Netzstruktur Zukunft schenken, dass das Internet global und frei bleibt. Zukunft wollen wir auch dem IGF schenken. Als der Digitalausschuss des Deutschen Bundestages im letzten Jahr mit einer Delegation das IGF in Paris besuchte, ist uns klar geworden, die Aufmerksamkeit von Parlamentariern der Welt muss stärker auf dieses Gremium gelenkt werden und umgekehrt, die Perspektive von Parlamentariern soll stärker in die Debatten über Internet Governance einfließen. Im Deutschen Parlament haben wir vor mehr als 5 Jahren einen Digitalausschuss eingerichtet. Er hat einen entscheidenden Anteil dazu beigetragen, das Verständnis im Parlament für den globalen Prozess der Digitalisierung und wie diese am besten zu gestalten ist, zu stärken. Aus der heutigen parlamentarischen Arbeit ist er nicht mehr wegzudenken. Ich wünsche mir, dass es dieser Veranstaltung ähnlich ergeht, denn wir hoffen, mit diesem Impuls eine Traditionslinie zu schaffen, die die zukünftigen Internet Governance Foren begleiten wird. Es wäre schön, wenn wir in einigen Jahren sagen können, dass wir die unterschiedlichen Positionen der Digitalpolitiker dieser Welt besser verstehen und dass dazu dieses Gesprächsformat entscheidend beigetragen hat. Wir wollen heute gemeinsam drängende Fragen unseres digitalen Zeitalters diskutieren und voneinander lernen. Wir haben uns diese Veranstaltung deshalb wie folgt vorgestellt. Wir haben vorab 4 Schwerpunktthemen identifiziert, die aktuell eine große Rolle in der politischen Diskussion spielen. Zu den einzelnen Themenkomplexen haben wir Abgeordnete des Deutschen Bundestages als Themenpaten gewinnen können. Die Themen sind erstens künstliche Intelligenz. Das Themengebiet umfasst zum Beispiel Fragen wie: Was verstehen wir unter KI, künstliche Intelligenz und sein Einfluss auf das Internet, Herausforderungen und Chancen, wie gehen wir mit ethischen Fragen um? Und zu den einzelnen Themengebieten haben wir auch nicht-parlamentarische Experten, die an die Thementische dazukommen. In dem Themengebiet künstliche Intelligenz wird es Susan Wegner von der Deutschen Telekom sein. Das zweite Thema lautet internationale Zusammenarbeit für ein sicheres, offenes und freies Internet und umfasst unter anderem Fragen wie zur derzeitigen Organisation für die Standardsetzung. Wie können diese gestärkt werden? Welche Rolle sollen wir Parlamentarier dabei spielen? Und zum Thementisch wird Sirin Unal und Rachel Ghetto kommen. Drittes Thema wird digitales Zeitalter, Fluch oder Segen für die Demokratie sein. Und es umfasst Fragen zur Rolle sozialer Netzwerke. Wer bestimmt das öffentliche Interesse? Und hierzu wird Qiang Hong Hu von der UNESCO zum Thementisch kommen. Das vierte Thema lautet Frieden und Digitalisierung sowie Schutz kritischer Infrastrukturen, also Internet, Stromerzeugung, Mobilfunk und Fragen zu Hacking, Überwachung, Exportkontrolle und digitaler Kriegsführung. Und hierzu werden die Experten Alexander Seger vom Council of Europe und Ronda Silva vom ICANN Board stoßen. Zuerst wird nun jeder Themenpate sich und sein Thema kurz vorstellen. Anschließend geht es in die kleineren Gruppen, in die inhaltliche Diskussion an die Tische. Wir laden Sie herzlich ein, sich nach den Impulsen der Themenpaten in die Gruppen zu begeben, an der Sie inhaltlich Interesse haben. Sie können dort gemeinsam mit den Themenpaten, Kolleginnen und Kollegen aus anderen Ländern und weiteren Interessierten über Ihre Perspektive diskutieren und spannende Gesprächspartner kennenlernen. Natürlich können Sie auch zwischen den Themenbereichen hin und her wechseln. Liebe Kolleginnen und Kollegen, das Internet hat zur Vernetzung der Welt beigetragen. Vernetzen auch Sie sich heute mit und untereinander, nicht nur digital, sondern ganz analog. Gehen Sie offen aufeinander zu, tauschen Sie sich aus, diskutieren Sie miteinander, kurzum, lernen Sie sich kennen. Bitte nutzen Sie diese Chance hier und heute. An den Thementischen werden keine Dolmetscher zur Verfügung stehen, aber ich denke, die Diskussionen werden dennoch lebhaft sein. Und jetzt wünsche ich Ihnen spannende Erkenntnisse, fruchtbare Diskussionen und viel Spaß und übergebe an den ersten Themenpaten meinen Kollegen Mario Brandenburg.
Hello everybody, welcome to the IGF, welcome to Berlin. My name is Mario Brandenburg. I'm a member of the German Parliament for the Free Democratic Party, and I'll host the artificial intelligence table. And in order to get the discussion going, I'll not explain what AI is. I guess if you're in the room, you will already know what it is, or at least have a meaning about it. So I'll bring up three, let's say, theses or thoughts, which I would be happy to discuss with you afterwards. And the first thing is, if we talk about AI, and some of us do it on a daily basis, and especially in a political context, you often forget that the perception of AI is very different depending to whom you talk. If it's somebody who only sees it in movies, then it's more or less a naked killer machine with an Austrian dialect traveling through time, or somebody annoyed by a chatbot if they try to order a pizza. So it's a real broad scope. And sometimes, even if I listen to speeches, and sometimes it happens to me as well, I think, do we really consider basically the perception of the people we talk to? And therefore, sometimes I think we might even rethink our terminology. And I want to give you one example. When I hear AI decided, or the decision was taken by AI. So if I think about the word decision, a decision is something with a meaning, with a purpose, maybe a part of a bigger strategy. And I'm not really sure if it is smart to talk about AI taking decisions. So to one extent, it scares people. And on the other hand side, if you take the example of a calculator, nobody would type in 2 + 2 and say the machine decided it's 4. Because we all want to know what this thing is doing, and we all know what it is doing. And the moment we talk about decisions taken by somebody, and we are not talking about super general AI, we're talking about the narrow stuff which is out there, I think basically we give too much power and we might scare some people. So this would be the first block, talking about terminology and perception. The second one, or the second topic, which I think would be interesting, AI and internet. So if we think back to the internet, how it was, let's call it 1.0, so it was open and full of dreams, and sometimes the web 2.0 feels a bit central and full of cat videos. So there must be something in the middle, and with web 3.0 coming up, the idea to decentralize, to re-democratize everything, I think this is a momentum and a chance, because the internet is as powerful as it never was before. Back in the days, the software developers of real life tried to shape the online world. And it worked. But right now, if you think about it, it somehow changed. If you just take shopping as an example. Before, the little city centers looked how they looked because people wanted to go there to shop. We needed parking lots. And some smaller city centers are dying because we all order online. And this has other implications to traffic and to everything. So we're slowly seeing that the online world is shaping the offline world. And with something like AI coming up, some decentralization technologies, edge computing, we are basically at a point where we can re-democratize the internet and might have to talk about standardization and basically interoperability and these type of things, because I think the run for miniaturization and make components smarter and smaller is basically over. If you think about big land machines or something, there is enough room, there is enough space for computing power. So we are at the beginning of a different game, and if we want to make it right, if we want to make it good for our people, we should better think about what we create. And the last part would be governance and ethics. So obviously we are the IGF, and if we see how much AI discussion is going on, how many strategies are out there, it becomes even harder to govern. So maybe the IGF needs a twin, the AIGF. So if it ever happens, invite me, I'm happy to talk. So, but I want to talk with you about how we could govern it and the ethics part as well, because I often meet people who tell me they are experts in AI ethics, or I get funny business cards of AI ethics. And I really don't know what this should be. So if there is an AI ethics guy in here, please explain me what that means. Because to me, there is ethics and our values, and there is AI. But I don't see the point in having AI ethics. So we have our values, don't do evil, don't be in So that's the stuff which was there, and it will be there. And there is AI, but I don't see AI ethics. But if there's somebody who can convince me that we need AI ethics, please go ahead and join my table. Thank you.
Vielen Dank, Mario Brandenburg. Als nächstes Ulrich Lechte.
Mr. Chair, thank you very much. Dear colleagues, dear ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ulrich Lechte. I'm member of the German Parliament, as everybody who's in charge of here today at the beginning. I didn't have to travel very far to come here, just coming by from Munich in the morning. Therefore, I would like to thank you all who came by from far away or nearby to discuss internet governance. A warm welcome to Berlin. In the German Parliament, I'm a member of the Committee of Foreign Affairs and also the chairman of its subcommittee on United Nations, International Organizations and Globalism. That's the point why I'm here today, because it's also a time for the United Nations today. So I'm especially responsible also for multilateral cooperation in the German Parliament. Also, I'm board member of the Forum of Young Parliamentarians in the IPU, the Interparliamentarian Union. In this capacity, I'm engaged to facilitate international exchange between parliamentarians on all levels, especially the global one. And therefore, I'm also very excited to meet you all here today and that so many people came to this convention today. The topic of the group, which I will moderate, is international cooperation to secure an open and free internet. You are the experts. I'm just the one who's going to be the guy leading the discussion at the table, and I'm looking forward to do that with you. And part of the time going on, I'm coming to an end and not taking my full 5 to 10 minutes, so that we have more time for discussions later on. Thank you very much.
Vielen Dank. Nächstes Anke Domscheit-Berg.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, theoretically, you should see something. I think if you have to listen probably to a language which is not your own, it's sometimes easier if you can see something. I want to shortly introduce myself. I'm also a German MP for the Left Party for 2 years now. My topics of special interest are the social impact of technology, and especially how you can combine the digital revolution with the social revolution, because I see a lot of potential, I just don't see it happening so far. I also deal with the topics of future of work, open everything from open source to open data, open government, and everything around freedom of the internet and protecting privacy. I have an IT industry background, but I have been an internet activist for quite some years and also a publicist on these topics. Within the parliament, I'm the party group spokesperson for the Left Party on internet policy and digitalization. I'm a speaker of my party in the Select Committee on Digitalization, and I'm a deputy member in two other committees, the Committee on Education, Research and Impact of Technology, and another committee on traffic and digital infrastructure. I'm also a member of the Enquete Commission on Artificial Intelligence and a member of the Advisory Board of Federal Networks Authority. Yeah, the question of the group I will be moderating after this short introduction is digital somehow killing democracy? Is it good or is it bad? And of course, it's not black nor white, but I would like to focus the debate afterwards on one topic, and that is digital monopolies. I believe that the extreme monopolization is against the DNA of the internet, which in itself is decentral, and it should be decentral again. So this is like poison for what the internet can do good, to have such big digital platform companies with, like Facebook, a significant share of the entire global population being a member, and 70% of all global traffic being routed via Facebook or Google. I think that's far too much. And the big question is, can you still regulate them? Or are they already too big? Have we passed that potential opportunity to do something against it? They do break laws, and they just laugh about the penalties they have to pay because they just have enough money. And their business models, apparently, and there is proof for that, are dangerous for democracy. We even saw spikes in violence and all these things, and I think you know what I'm talking about. There are quite some initiatives in Germany and the European Union dealing with this topic overall. In Germany, we have the already mentioned Enquete Commission on Artificial Intelligence, which is currently developing recommendations for the German Bundestag. It will work 2 years, 1 year already passed, and there will be a final report next year in September. We also had a governmental commission on competition law 4.0, dealing also with digital platforms and how to regulate them, and then already finished a commission on data ethics. They also published a report. I believe they are available in English language. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm pretty sure. In the European Union, we have the PSI Directive on Public Sector Information, also called Open Data Directive. And there is, in the process of establishment, a France-German work group on disruptive innovations and AI, and all these topics I mentioned before will be discussed there as well. In parallel, already existing for a while is a high-level expert group on AI, which primarily looks at industry and economy. Yeah, what I would like to discuss in the group, so here come many questions. These are things we discuss in Germany very heavily. It's how you can actually regulate those big monopolies. They function in a global economy, in the global internet, so how can you regulate them on a national basis? And if not, on what basis and how can you regulate them? Should they actually be broken up? I personally think they are too big and they have to be broken up, but opinions can differ. And I would like to discuss with parliamentarians if they share the same idea, how could it actually be done? Or if you don't share the idea, or additionally, could be a forced interoperability be a way to break the lock-in effect, the network effect, and just diminish their power? And I do not mean data portability, I mean real interoperability between services, so that other smaller services can get a chance. And as long as we have the situation as it is, what can regulators do to minimize anti-democratic impacts of those monopolies? And how can we help grow and foster those existing non-profit, open source, transparent, and for the common goal-oriented alternatives for what I call social infrastructure of the internet, which is social networking, which is also search. It's type of an infrastructure, and I think you should not leave it to profit organizations. Yeah, so let's discuss, if you come to my group table, whether you have the same debates and what are maybe the ideas you are discussing in those debates. Do you have regulation on these aspects already implemented or in the process of planning? What could work? What could probably not work? And why not? For example, the issue of interoperability is discussed very controversially, so I'd like to know of your ideas on that. And whatever is a burning debate in your respective countries and parliaments, I would really like to know, and I would also like to know how we can combine forces to bring this forward together. Thanks.
Thanks. Last but not least, Dr. Jens Zimmermann.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. My name is Jens Zimmermann. I'm also a member of the German Bundestag, and I'm the spokesperson on digitization for the Social Democrats, for the German Labour Party. And the topic I'm offering on the table after this introduction is peace in the digital age and securing critical infrastructure. And if we think back, the internet was invented for freedom, for openness, for bringing people together. And looking back at the last decades, we see it grew dramatically. And today, it's in many lives, everyday business. It plays a critical role to run our economies, to run nearly everything. And it is definitely, it became a critical infrastructure. And being a critical infrastructure, it also became part of conflicts, and it is definitely one of the areas debated for future conflicts, and it is at the very heart of the United Nations to prevent war and to help to gain peace. And I think it's crucial and it's obvious that we need to find common ground, how to maintain peace in the digital sphere. And we've seen in the past attacks in the digital sphere by state and by non-state actors. And in many countries, and also in Germany, it is debated whether or not armies need to have offensive capacities and how to deal with attacks. A recent debate in Germany is a debate about so-called hackbacks, so what to do if a cyber attack is imminent and whether or not to counterattack. So these fields, I think, are crucial to have more debates on, to find common ground and to define new international rules, and also to find a way to apply the rule of law also in that digital field. And it's perfectly linked to talk in that area about the infrastructure and the securing critical infrastructure. We are talking about the Internet of Things, so it's very famous to have these examples of your refrigerator talking to your oven or stuff like that, which seems very often quite funny, thinking into the consequences if an infrastructure like this is attacked or is obvious. And we've also seen in international debates the question about the security of fiber optic cables in our oceans, and most recently the debate about the reliability of hardware providers for providing the infrastructure for the 5G networks. So these are all areas where we need to debate much, much more, I think, and it's crucial for our societies to secure these infrastructures, and I'm very much looking forward to an interesting debate with you. Thank you very much.
Vielen Dank. Jetzt bitte ich alle, sich, die interessiert sind, an den Tischen zusammenzufinden, sodass die Diskussionen an den Thementischen jeweils stattfinden können. Und wir versammeln uns am großen Tisch wieder um 15:45 Uhr.